by people, that means what, how the families suffer. If a member of the family is there for a certain limited time, but imagine what happens to the families who are deceased there, and their lifeline is cut off.
It's also important to keep in mind that Egypt is second to Israel in foreign aid, so there is a condition there, and what we can do in the United States is to begin to put pressure on the constituents that are elected who end up supporting the Israeli occupation. That we can begin to educate ourselves as Americans, and this is part of what's happening all across the nation, is learning more about the issues at hand, how we're connected to Israel, and the decisions that we make in terms of the products that we buy, or the companies that support the occupation, Motorola, Caterpillars, for example, the BDS, the boycott, the SMAC, the sanction movement, which was very successful in ending South Africa apartheid, can also be used as an instrument here in the United States.
Any other questions? I don't want to be the first. What distinction would you make between Zionism and the Jewish faith?
Zionism is about support for a state of Israel, and there are different degrees within Zionism. There are Zionists who are more peaceful and do want to make peace, and then there's hardcore Zionists who say Israel is right no matter what it's doing, and you can't criticize Israel at all. Zionism is about this political movement to establish the state, and now that the state is established, to support it. It is different from Judaism in that Judaism is a religion rather than a nationalism. Zionism is about a nationalism that's supposed to be for all Jewish people. And Zionism sells itself to all Jewish people saying, hey, we're your country. Not all Jewish people buy into it. There are a lot of anti-Zionist Jews who say, hey, wait a minute, that's not me. I don't like what your state government's doing, and I'm against it. So Zionism is a political movement, whereas Judaism is a religion. And then there's also the Jewish people, who are not necessarily religious, but have a lineage that descends from people who practice Judaism. So there's some distinctions.
Shannon.
Yes.
Well, our documentary is too long, but we'd like to show just certain sections, not the whole documentary. I know you're going to show that documentary another time, but we'd just like to show maybe a section here, a section here, if that's okay with everybody. I think it's important because you need to see the work that other people are doing, just so far as trying to get to this issue. It's up. Come on. You're okay with that. I know. Come on.
Can you listen to that?
It'd just be a few sections.
The trailer version. There we go. The trailer. Let's try to keep it close to five, please.
Any more questions?
We're running out of time.